새 하늘과 새 땅을 천주를 주관하여 주시옵소서. 천국의 영적 역사를 태풍과 같이 불어주시어 온 세계의 죄악을 씻어내시고 온 인류가 천일국의 백성들이 되도록 인도하여 주시옵소서. 말씀과 참 사랑의 삶, 그리고 천일국의 비전, 천상에 오르신 참 아버님으로부터 위대한 유업을 상속받은 통일가의 당면한 숙명적 과제는 무엇인가? 그것은 두 말할 나위 없습니다. 바로 천일국 기원절 승리, 실체적 천일국의 완성입니다. 이를 위해 우리는 무엇을 해야 하겠습니까?
우리가 할 일을 무엇이냐 하면은 두 가지가 있습니다. 한 가지는 땅에 계시는 어머님을 받들어 모시고 참 어머님과 하나 되어서 나가는 것이고, 둘째는 참 부모님께서 저희들에게서 원죄는 정산해 주셨지만은 그 외에 타락으로 들어온 교악의 요소는 아직도 남아 있습니다. 그렇기 때문에 우리는 우리 자신 속에서 죄와 악을 청산하는 일, 이것을 우리의 또한 중요한 책임으로 알고 나가지 않으면 안 되겠습니다.
박보희 회장의 보고 기도는 우리의 심정을 대변합니다.
참 아버님, 염려치 마시옵소서. 염려치 마시옵소서. 이제 저희들은 울음을 그치고 두 주먹을 불끈 쥐고 참 어머님을 모시고 천일국을 세우겠나이다.
한평생 참아버님과 함께 뜻길을 개척해온 참어머님. 6살 되던 해 기독교 신령교단으로부터 하늘의 신으로 축복을 받으신 뒤 수시로 닥쳐오는 거센 역경을 딛고 가슴에 홀로 안고 살아온 성정은 참부모, 참스승, 평화왕의 길이었습니다.
영계가 어머니에 대해서만 순진합니다. 여러분이 생활 대가에 있어서 아버지 앞에 지금 뿐만이 아니라 어머니의 느낌들까지 밝혀주야만 효원이 받는다. 알겠어?
네. 하나님의 참사랑을 중심삼고 참아버님과 일심, 일령, 일화가 되신 참어머니. 그렇습니다. 우리에겐 참아버님의 대신자 참어머님이 계십니다. 성운 이후 1차 7년 노정을 걸으시며 말 못할 복귀 섭리의 수많은 사연을 모두 품고 참어머님의 승리적 기대 위에 선포된 수많은 섭리. 특히 1992년 여성시대 개막 이후 아버님 옆에 서시어 장자권, 부모권, 왕권 복귀의 성업을 완료하신 1999년 2월에 천주 승리 축하 선포 공로패도 받으셨습니다. 그 전후에도 아버님께서는 휘호도 주시고 그리고 시도 주시고 말로 다할 수 없는 사랑과 감사를 어머님께 표현하셨습니다.
우리의 목적지는 세상 저 끝이지만 우리의 출발점은 바로 내 마음과 몸이 참 사랑을 중심으로 하나 되는 데서부터 시작되어야 한다는 사실을 잊지 마시지요. 내 가정이 영원한 행복과 참 사랑의 정착지가 될 때 비로소 우리가 바라는 이상의 나라, 이상의 세계가 결실되는 것임을 명심해야겠습니다.
하늘의 참아버님의 뜻이란 절대 신앙, 절대 사랑, 절대 복종으로 승리에 나옵니다. 여식이 사망을 일으켜 성화하지 못하여 불편하신 성체를 입으시니 천정중 경련이 둘러보시니 어머니께 고맙다는 말씀을 충전해 하시며 지상의 과업을 맡겨주십니다.
참 부모님께서는 다 이루셨습니다. 완성, 완결, 완료하셨습니다. 이제 태국의 정착은 우리 자녀들의 몫이 되었습니다. 태국의 기본 단위가 되는 중국의 사람과 가정을 이루어야 할 새 시대, 새 사명을 주님께 되었습니다. 우리 다 함께 용서와 화해와 통일의 새 시대를 열어가는 참 어머님을 모시고 천일국 정착을 하여 다 함께 전진합시다.
기원전 하나님을 전시해 모시고 실천 신지를 열어 영원한 해방 속광을 구가하게 된 영생의 참 아버님이 그렇게 그리고 그리시던 그 천상에 계신 참 아버님, 지상에 계신 참 어머님, 오늘 성인식을 맞아 저희는 참 부모님을 모시고 실체적 천일국 완성과 기원절 승리를 향해 사생결단 전력투 실천 공행할 것입니다. 저희는 참 아버님의 위대한 유산을 상속받은 자랑스러운 천일국 백성입니다. 우리에겐 정지란 없습니다. 여기서 멈출 수는 없습니다. 오직 전진 또 전진만 있습니다. 천일국 기원절 그날 아버님 용안에 환한 미소 지으시오. Let us put our best foot forward and live our lives while embracing the will and teaching of our true Lord. Until the day true mother can smile bright and true mother can laugh with joy. 세상을 향해 강하고 담대하게 나아가겠습니다. 승리하겠습니다.
천일국 기원의 새 아침 이날을 축복하듯 온 세상 백색의 옷으로 갈아입고 설렘 가득한 발걸음들이 역사적인 현장으로 향합니다. 시마송의 꽃들과 천일국의 사진인 장엄한 천정궁의 무대가
천정궁 스테이지 welcomed all the members. From now on, the true parents of heaven, earth, and humankind will be here with us together in Chongxin Peace World Center. We will commence the Chunilguk registration blessing from now on. The Foundation Day, which is the start of the substantial Chunilguk. Members from around the world give big round of applause and show and express their gratitude as they ushered in this historic Foundation Day.
신천,
a new heaven, a new earth. After the fall of men, this new day we all hoped for, the joys that were being conveyed from the members' heart. Everyone looked so filled with goodness. This moment, true father, true parents, offered so much conditions to be able to set up this foundation. And their conditions were conveyed to us on that day. We felt indescribable gratitude for presenting Heavenly Parent and true parents of heaven, earth, and humankind a poor prayer. was offered that day. True parents have achieved complete unity and liberated God, and today, finally, we are celebrating the best day, Foundation Day. Today, Heavenly Parents, how long have you waited for this day? A day that has unprecedented in human history, a day when the new heaven and new earth are starting, where true Father came on earth to liberate God and save humankind, and who has been victorious and finally has become the substantial self of God. And now we have the Chunilguk coronation ceremony. We want to say thank you again for letting us, for giving us this opportunity to really participate in this historic day. Heavenly parents and true parents, he came as the true Adam and completed the providence of restoration and reached complete unity with true Mother and reached complete unity with Heavenly Parent. Please give them again another big round of applause. Brothers and sisters, the true parents became completely one with Heavenly Parents and completed, concluded, and perfected the entire process of restoration. True Father's victorious life as the owner of true love. This was presented to True Father. All families representing the spiritual world and physical world. Not only those on earth, but thousands and thousands of spiritual beings are participating here today. True Mother, true parents entered with the true grandchildren, the true children. For the indemnity, true parents who walked the sacrificial path to pay indemnity. Their hearts, the sacrificial hearts, were conveyed. True parents, true making entrance. Please give a big round of applause to the true parents.
Welcome the true parents of heaven and earth and humankind. Munhyun-jin and Moon-kuk-chan are dedicating the heavenly cell to true parents. Now, a dedication of the Chan Sung-kyung and the Royal Heavenly Scepter. Chan Sung-kyung and the Heavenly Royal Scepter. Chan Sung-kyung was compiled through a compilation the Chonang scepter was dedicated to true parents, and Chan Sung-kyung was presented to true parents. Applies again to true parents. True parents proclaim Chan Eun-guk. True parents, heavenly parent, and true parents of heaven, earth, and humankind. The King of Peace. I declare to Heavenly Parent, I have named the country as Chan Eun-guk, and the national flower is rose and lilies, and the national bird as the crane, and the Chan Eun-guk national anthem. I present and dedicate all these to you today in 2013, January 13. I proclaim the first year of Chan Eun-guk. With the ushering in of a new heaven, new earth, applause spread all throughout the hall. This moment when a new history started this place, this venue. give another big round of applause again to our true parents of heaven, earth, and humankind. Because of the traffic and members were still coming in, so I'm asking the members to please fill in those seats. And as I have a few announcements to make for those offering with flowers, pay flower tribute, and so after the prayer, the floral tribute program, so I would like to welcome our main MC, Dr. Yang Changshek. Please give him a lot. Please welcome with a big round of applause.
It was also covered extensively by three Korean broadcasting stations and major newspapers.
World leaders, elder members, and blessed families from around the world. Good morning. Today, I am Dr. Yang Changshek, and the executive chairman of the Songhua Memorial, and I'll be your MC today. I'd first like to sincerely thank all leaders and blessed families who have come to this memorial ceremony from around the world to cherish memories of True Father despite your busy schedules. I sincerely thank you. This memorial ceremony today is being viewed by blessed families from around 194 countries. On the first anniversary of True Father's ascension, we look back at True Father's 93-year noble life and how he completed the entire providence and ascended to heaven upon this victorious foundation. So now the time has come for us to conduct the memorial ceremony to cherish the life of Reverend Sun Myung-mun. So all blessed families of the education community who could not join us here today are viewing the memorial ceremony via webcast from 194 countries with us here in Chongxin Peace World Center. True Father ascended at the age of 93 in the seventh day of the seventh month by the heavenly calendar in 2012, September 3rd at 1:54 a.m. And following his ascension, around 25,000 people from Korea alone came to pay their tribute here in Cheonjong-gun, Chongxin Peace World Center, and memorial altars installed all over the country during the 13-day tribute period. And around 800 people from 195 countries participated in this ceremony. And thanks to these, we were able to make True Father's passage to heaven into a glorious passing. In addition, 1,842 VIPs from Korea and abroad, including heads of states and first ladies, came to pay their tributes, and 59 press companies directly came here to cover and film the event. Around 3,500 reports on father's ascension was made in the news around the world.
3만여 명이 운집한 가운데 참아버님의 인류 구원을 위한 희생과 헌신적인 생애를
On September 17, around 30,000 people participated in the Universal Songhwa ceremony and we could testify in front of humanity to a father's life of sacrifice and devotion for the salvation of humanity. The Songhwa ceremony for the Messiah of humanity and King of Universal Peace was solemnly and grandly held. On that day, 50,000 roses and lilies beautifully and harmoniously decorated the stage, making Father's passage to heaven glorious. Leaders from around the world and loving members. Today marks one full year after True Father's passing. The true parents of heaven, earth, and humankind came on earth as the Savior, Messiah, returning Lord, and the true parents, overcoming all sorts of trials in the process. He dedicated his entire life to the liberation of heavenly parent, the salvation of humankind, and the building of a peaceful world. And finally, on January 13, 2001, He could liberate and completely free God through the coronation ceremony of God's kingship. And on January 15 and 31 of 2009, True Parents conducted the coronation for the realm of liberation for God, the King of Kings, three times. And on July 8, 2010, True Parents perfected and completed and concluded the entire providence of restoration through the Cosmic Assembly for the settlement of the true parents of heaven, earth, and humankind, and for the proclamation of the word by God's substantial self. On this day, True Father and True Mother perfected, completed, and concluded complete unity and proclaimed to the world that they had completed all responsibility and mission on earth. And with this, True Parents manifested the ideal of God of night, the God of day, the King of the Universal Peace, and the True Parents of heaven, earth, and humankind, and could become the substantial self of God. And last January 13, by the heavenly calendar in 2013, True Parents proclaimed the first year of Chenalguk as we ushered in Foundation Day of Chenalguk and pricelessly bestowed the grace of the Chenalguk Foundation registration blessing to humanity. As we commemorate this first Songhwa memorial, let us all express our gratitude to True Father for dedicating his entire life for the liberation of God, the salvation of humanity, and the realization of a peaceful world, and for living as peace-loving global citizen until his ascension. So please give a strong round of applause to True Parents with the determination to live like True Parents and resemble them. Thank you. I am sincerely grateful to Heavenly Parent for giving us the glory to directly participate in this historic memorial ceremony. So let us all get ready for the pre-event programs. Respected leaders, world leaders, blessed families around the world, the true parents will now make an entrance. Please stand from your seats. Now, the true parents of heaven, earth, and humankind will make an entrance. Please welcome her with a big round of applause, everyone. First, true mother will offer flowers to true father. We'll make a flower tribute to true father. Please give another big round of applause again to our true mother. Next, let us all offer a bow to our true parents. We'll offer a standing bow. Bow. of our true parents of heaven, earth, and humankind here at Chongshan Peace World Center, we're about to commence this historic ceremony in memory of true father together of the spiritual world and physical world. Reverend Sun Myung-mun, the true parents of heaven, earth, and humankind, was born with the heavenly seal of the Savior, Messiah, returning Lord, and true parents. Later, he dedicated his life to liberate heavenly parent who was suffering as a result of the fall of man, and also saved humanity who were under Satan's shackles through the blessing. And furthermore, he dedicated his entire life for the realization of an eternal world of peace, which God had envisioned in the beginning. Respected world leaders, leaders, elder members, blessed families, and brothers and sisters, by realizing God in humanity's hope, which are the liberation of God, the salvation of humanity, and the foundation to achieve world peace, in 6,000 years, true father could become victorious and stand as God's substantial self. And we're now about to commence this precious memorial ceremony to cherish the memory of true father exactly 1 year since his entrance to heaven. Today, blessed families from 194 countries are with us here in Chongshan Peace World Center via webcast. And this is also a solemn time with billions of spiritual beings in the spirit world and humanity on earth coming together to join this memorial. So from now on, we'll start Reverend Sun Myung-mun Universal Songhua Memorial. True Father, first of all, we'll sing the Chonilguk National Anthem. Everyone please stand up and sing alongside the accompaniments. Oh! next. We'll have a report prayer. Please be seated. The report prayer representing everyone here today. Archbishop George Augustine Stanlings will give us the report prayer.
Let us pray.
기도하시겠습니다.
Our most beloved heavenly parent,
사랑하는 하늘
we invoke
부모님,
your majestic name and recognize you for who you are.
하늘 부모님의 거룩한 이름을 저희들 입에 올리고 또 하늘 부모님의 거룩하심과 위대하심을 저희들은 지금 이곳에서 호우하고 올리옵나이다. 이 지구에 천지인 참 부모님 보내주셔서 정말로 감사합니다. 그 천지인 참 부모님은 문섬영 총재님 그리고 사랑하시는 아내 한 학자분이십니다. 참 부모님께서는 이 지구상에 하나님의 왕국을 다시 건설하기 위해서 오셨습니다. 그리고 인류 구원 복귀 역사를 위해서 참 부모님을 사용하셨으며 참 부모님에게 그러한 권한과 권위를 주셨습니다. 저희들 오늘 이곳에 모여 승리하신 참 아버님의 성화 1주년을 기념하기 위해 모였사옵나이다. 오늘 저희들은 아버님의 삶과 아버님의 유업과 아버님께서 남기신 모든 그 유산을 경축하는 그러한 기회를 갖기 위해 이곳에 모였습니다. 그리고 아버님께서 남기신 그 열매를 통해서 저희들은 참 아버님께서 이곳에 모든 인류를 복귀하기 위해 오신 분이라는 사실을 알 수가 있습니다. 비록 참 아버님께서는 육적으로 돌아가셨으나 육적으로만 돌아가셨으나 저희들은 참 아버님을 이제 직접 볼 수 없다는 그러한 생각에 너무나도 슬픔나이다. 비록 참 아버님께서는 연기로 돌아가셨지만 참 아버님의 영은 저희들에게 다시 임재하고 계심을 저희들은 믿사옵나이다. 이제 하늘 부모님과 참 아버님은 하나이시며 어디 계시든지 어디 가시든지 아버님께서 계실 것을 믿습니다.
Thank you, O Heavenly Parent, that in true father's physical passing,
참 아버님의 육적 성화를 통해서 성화를 참 아버님께서 육적으로 성화를 하셨지만 하늘 부모님께서는 참 어머님을 저희들을 위해 준비해 주셔서 저희들을 지도하고 저희들을 이끌어 주시도록 하셨습니다. 그리고 저희들은 참 어머님을 따라서 저희들의 원수를 사랑하고 영원한 평화의 세계를 건설하기 위해 참 어머님을 도와서 노력을 하고 있사옵나이다. 참 아버님께서는 영계로 가시기 전에 참 어머님의 손을 잡으시면서 기도하셨습니다. 그리고 그 기도에서 참 아버님께서는 본인의 생애를 하나님께 완결하여 되돌려드린다고 말씀하셨습니다. 모든 것을 다 이루었다고 말씀을 하셨습니다. 그리고 이제 참 아버님께서 말씀하신 그 천일국 창건의 시대가 이제 저희들에게 왔습니다. 오로지 참 아버님께서만이 그리고 참 어머님께서만이 참 부모의 피 흘리는 그러한 어려운 고난에 대해서 알고 계십니다. 그리고 참 부모님께서는 인류를 복귀하기 위해서 너무나도 많은 고난을 감내하셔야만 하셨습니다. 이제 저희들은 참 가정을 통해서 그리고 참 부모님을 통해서 축복을 받은 모든 사람들을 통해서 인류의 운명은 해방의 길로 나아가게 될 것입니다. 이 영광스러운 순간을 축복하여 주시옵소서.
We reported off of this prayer in our names and in the names of George and Saomi Stalin.
이 기도를 우리 모두의 이름 그리고 조지 스탈린의 이름으로 기도를 아뢰었사옵나이다.
representing everyone, I would like to ask all those giving floral tributes to come forward.
먼저,
first of all, the true family and the family representing Ho Chi Minh and the representatives of the five saints, saints in the spiritual world will offer floral tributes to True Father. So I would like to ask all second and third true children to come forward on stage and Hong Moni and the wives of the five saints to come up on stage. Reverend Moon and Mrs. Dr. Hak Cha Han Moon have 13 children and 70 grandchildren. So representative grandchildren, true grandchildren, and true children will come forward and offer floral tributes. Those true children behind, please come forward and pay your floral tributes to True Father. Next, leaders representing the 194 mission countries will come forward to offer floral tributes. Next, all national leaders representing the 194 countries will offer floral tributes. Continental presidents and national leaders representing are making their floral tributes right now.
So continental directors and representatives are offering floral tribute. And elder members and their representatives please come forward and present your formal tribute.
Dr. Walsh, please wait.
And the representatives of the peace ambassadors, please be prepared. So the peace ambassadors' representatives, please enter. Please approach. And the representatives of the public officials of Korea and Japan will offer their floral tribute. My apologies, ladies and gentlemen. The MC is introducing some of the government officials and high leaders who are offering their floral tribute to Father's memory. These are the peace ambassadors who helped True Father while he was alive in his peace activities. And now, we have leaders from 70 nations around the world to participate in this event. First, the leaders from IOC will offer their floral tribute. Our apologies again, ladies and gentlemen. He, MC, is introducing the leaders from around the world to offer their floral tribute.
John Cloud Dragon, Francis Hamuliwon, Flora Robina, Kosovo Kaywon, Luis Tiburus Juan, Philippine Desanim, Felix Carlos Pariba, Uruguay Hamuliwon, Karen Lisbeth, Ricardo Coniel, Dominica Gungawe Kaywon, Rally Thomas Vigili, Washington Times Hajang, John Lawrence Mobbins, Papua New Guinea, Bougainville Tachiyang Sujang,
and we have Mrs. Janas Mainanias. We have Catherine Lumumba.
Okay,
she's from the Republic of Congo. Chan Kumbhanijaya. And we have Dr. Thomas Walsh. Now, representing True Father's relatives, they will offer their formal tribute. Thank you very much. Everybody who is here today, I know that you all want to offer your formal tribute. After the main event, we will keep this likeness of Father. And also outside by the fountain, there's a place where more than 6,000 people can offer their floral tribute, so please use that place. Now, on this historical occasion, we have created a video to explain the works that Father has left for us. As a peace-loving global citizen, this video covers the entire life of True Father, who dedicated to the liberation of Heavenly Parent, the salvation of humanity, and a peaceful world. Let us all watch the video. Father, you were the truth, love, and life. Through you, we met God. We felt true love. And through you, we gained the wisdom to defeat the world, and we developed courage. More than anything else, you have precisely
given us the precious gift,
gave us everything you had.
Father, you were the manifestation of the Word.
True Father was an essential Word, and He loved the Word more than anyone else. When conveying the Word, drops of perspiration kept falling as you dedicated yourself completely with the heart to save even one person. The entire newly liberated heaven and earth, everything that has been realized for God's kingdom and transcendental heaven and earth, comprised the original country in which all people must live.
The teachings you gave us after staying up for nights
not only awakened us, but has also become the standard in our lives and is becoming the scripture of humanity. True parents completely devoted themselves to open a new era. Under the vision of one big family under God, leaders around the world, including world top leaders, are participating in the peace movement. An interfaith movement that has contributed to the holding of hands by exclusive religious leaders and the suppression of religious conflicts. A big step that brought the Cold War to an end and opened a new horizon for the unification of North Korea and South Korea. educational institutions fostering world citizens, mass media organizations forming the right public opinion, aimed at reducing the poor-rich gap between the East and West through the standardization of technologies used in the industries around the world.
Last year, late in the summer, was the most sweltering ever.
Last year,
our shop heart still trembled even today. Thinking you would always be as healthy as a youth, the regret we felt was even more intense. Father, you completely dedicated your life and tried to give everything. Just as Jesus redeemed the sins of humanity by shedding blood on the cross, you had to indemnify the sins of the world by enduring the pain the numerous hospital equipment inflicted on your body during your fight against this disease for about a month. The entire unification community prayed and prayed for your recovery. However, Father, who proclaimed, "I have accomplished everything," went to the original homeland, leaving this final prayer behind. By the heavenly calendar, true Father's ascension, he ascended after completing and concluding the providence of restoration. However, your ascension was a bolt from the blue to us. We could not believe your sudden leaving. No matter how many tears rolled down from our two eyes, it did not alleviate our yearning and miserable hearts. The queue of leaders from around the world and righteous people who came to pay tribute saw no end for 13 days. With eternal love. On the way to Bonhyangwon, Chun Song San, Father, you had to leave the cries of members who had come for you behind, and had to move forward with lingering heavy steps. How difficult your part must have been. Silent tears, the more we long for you. We sincerely beseech you to come into our hearts at any time. We pray that your love, your hope, vividly revive eternity at all times. A noble life and accomplishments that cannot be inscribed within the heavenly scroll. The path you followed has become the way of life. Your accomplishments have become the cornerstone of peace. The teachings you left behind have become the light of love. True parents, you made the thorny path of restoration into a broad and level path. You enlarged the narrow door of the kingdom of heaven and overcame all ordeals and painful persecutions with your immense heart. After the ascension, True Mother became one with True Father in heaven. True Mother has been investing everything at the front line of the providence in order to accomplish God's will. Following the publication of Chenzhengyang and Pyeonghwagyang, we dedicate the Chenhongyu Constitution in front of heaven today. World leaders and law experts based on the making of the Chenhongyu Constitution on some parents' teachings. The Constitution could be completed through their complete dedication and wisdom. A new age has been opened now that we have the teachings and laws needed to establish and rule the ideal world. Alongside this Constitution, we also dedicate all public assets around the world to you. With this, we have established the Chenhongyu Mongmanse frame. Beloved Father, on this first anniversary of your ascension, please open the pearl gates of heaven and bring down spiritual wonders of all might on earth. Please help us realize the big idea of the completion of Chenhongyu as we attend Mother on earth. The returning world resolved all of God's 6,000 year resentment. True parents gave us born again lives. The true emperor of Chenhongyu with holiness and virtue, the emperor of absolute victory over the whole open, the new era after the coming of heaven. Please govern the cosmos and allow the whole earth to enjoy the reign of peace.
He truly lived a glorious life. Now, we will welcome our guests to the stage in order to offer Father remarks of commemoration. Chairman Lee Chul-sung will offer a remark, and he is a prominent figure of Korea who is applauded as an elder senator of the nation, a representative independent activist of the last generation acknowledged by Dr. Lee Seung-man and Kim Gu, one of the first people to lead the democratization and industrialization era of Korea. He was a seven-time elected parliament member, was the opposition party president, and is one of the leaders who led Korea through modern history. He and True Father had a deep connection as were sworn, and they were sworn brothers. He was one of the first ones who came to Cheongpyeong after hearing the news of the Songhwa of True Father. Let us all welcome Chairman Lee Seung-chul with a warm round of applause. ladies and gentlemen, today is the first anniversary of Reverend Sun Myung Moon's passing to the spirit world, a rite called Songhwa. I consider it a great privilege to speak in honor of his memory before all of you here today, who have come from around the world to pay respects to our beloved Reverend Sun Myung Moon. First of all, I would like to offer my deepest condolences to Mrs. Dr. Hakja Han Moon and to the bereaved family. Standing on this stage brings me back memories of last year when I came hurriedly with great sadness in my heart to Cheonjong-mun, where Reverend Sun Myung-moon's body was resting. Ladies and gentlemen, today I offer these most sincere words of commemoration to honor our Reverend Sun Myung-moon, a great man who has contributed to the establishment and democratization of this proud nation, the greatest nation since the era of Dangun, with its founding spirit of freedom, independence, democracy, and unification. Ladies and gentlemen, who was Reverend Sun Myung-moon, whom we have come here to remember? Since his birth and throughout 90 years of his life until his departure, Reverend Sun Myung-moon's life was filled with difficulties from the Japanese occupation, the Second World War, independence, and the subsequent division of the North and South, as well as the tragedy of Korean War. Even in the midst of conflict between North and South Korea, Reverend Sun Myung-moon transcended the barriers of nation, race, and religion. He is a true leader, teacher, and a great man of peace who has strived to create a world of peace. He is truly the eternal symbol of peace. He is a great man who has lived his life practicing the ideal of the unity of king, teacher, and father, an ideal which has been cherished by our people for a very long time. This man, this great man, did not just come and go. We have not a shred of doubt that he is still here with us in our hearts. You who who have gathered here today from all around the world are the very, very evidence of this. Ladies and gentlemen, 10 years ago on July 17, 2003, when the first Peace Cup tournament was held in Suwon, Korea, I made a promise with Reverend Sun Myung-moon to form a tie of sworn brothers. Here, I also promised him that even though we are old men nearing 90 years of age, we will liberate our brothers in the north, achieve the reunification. When I stood at the forefront of the tour to demonstrate the Korean people's gratitude to the 16 nations that participated in the Korean War as part of the UN peacekeeping forces, I did so as a part of the preparation to fulfill that promise of reunification. This project was the first of its kind. Not even the Korean government or its people had considered doing this over the past 60 years. Reverend Sun Myung-moon, this was all a preparation for the reunification of North and South Korea. Ladies and gentlemen, there was no such person in the history of this nation. Reverend Sun Myung-moon put his life on the line when he went out to the north to meet Kim Il-sung to discuss the Korean reunification. There, he urged Kim Il-sung, holding his hands, to give up the Juche ideal and accept his reunification thought. And then emphasized that that was the only way to achieve the reunification of our nation. His unwavering spirit of love for our nation and our people has served as a great model and infused us with great courage. Now, the promise I made with Reverend Sun Myung-moon will soon be realized by the efforts of our descendants. When we look at what is happening in the world and in North Korea, it is only a matter of time before the people of North Korea gain freedom. Reverend Moon, please be assured of this. happening in the world and in the North Korea. It is only a matter of time before the people of North Korea gain freedom. So, Reverend Moon, please be assured of this. Ladies and gentlemen, why have we come here today? Needless to say, we have come here to protect the great teachings of Reverend Moon, who walked the course of the true parent of humankind, true teacher and true leader of peace. We have come here today in order to inherit Reverend Moon's teachings and make them blossom so that his wishes are realized. In Korea, there is a saying, only when the servants work properly, the master will live as a master. There is also a saying, students make their teachers shine. Also, they say that to maintain is more difficult than to create. And also, only when the children behave properly, the parents will be respected by others as well. You, the people who uphold Reverend Sun Myung Moon and Mrs. Dr. Hak Ja Han Moon as the eternal true parents, true teacher, and true leader, are you not their servants, their students, and their children? You are the ones who are chosen from the 7 billion people of the earth, and you are blessed with receiving the teachings of Reverend Moon while he was still alive.
When I judge people, it is unbearable.
You received his love like no other. I would like to ask you to offer your sincere devotion so that Reverend Moon's lifelong dreams and wishes can be sown upon the earth that is you, and so that they can bear countless fruits. Ladies and gentlemen, we must not forget, even for one moment, about the sincere efforts of Dr. Hak Ja Han Moon, who now stays here with us, to continue the great works of Reverend Moon. We should always be grateful to her. Ladies and gentlemen, as we face this meaningful first year anniversary of Reverend Moon's passing, we must move beyond our own selfish interests, become more grateful and more united around Dr. Hak Ja Han Moon. We must not forget that the eyes of this world are watching us to see if we can practice the teachings left by Reverend Moon. Ladies and gentlemen, I urge you with all my heart to become the lantern of hope and the subject of people's praise.
Ladies and gentlemen,
want to pray with a loyal heart for the eternal life and happiness of Reverend Sun Myung-moon again. I hereby conclude my speech. Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you, Mr. Lee. Mr. Lee Chul-sung gave us a very moving remark, very moving speech. Thank you very much. Now, Mr. Songta, who is the head monk of the Bulguksa, the Buddhist temple, will offer us a remark, a commemoration remark. He is from the Joge order of Korean Buddhism, and he is a head monk of one of the most famous Buddhist temple of that Joge order. The commemorative speech for the first anniversary of the Songhwa of Reverend Sun Myung-moon. Respected Mrs. Dr. Hakja Han-moon, leaders from around the world, distinguished guests and members of the Family Federation for World Peace and Unification. It is my great honor to stand before you here today to represent Buddhism on this occasion of the first anniversary of the Universal Songhwa of Sun Myung-moon, the true parent of heaven, earth, and humankind. As you are well aware, Reverend Sun Myung-moon lived a truly selfless life, offering everything he had in order to create a peaceful world for humankind. We cannot make a simple judgment of who he really was. It is because Reverend Sun Myung-moon blazed a trail and left a truly vast and enduring legacy. Reverend Moon is generally known to the people of the world as a religious leader and the founder of religion. Some people see him as a peace activist, thinker, and educator. Some people regard him as the Messiah who gave his life to this world in order to realize peace. However, these simple words are not enough to encompass the greatness that defines the man named Reverend Sun Myung-moon. As he so eloquently stated, when someone tells me even just a word of sympathy for the life I lived, tears begin to fall like a waterfall from my eyes. Such has been Reverend Moon's eventful life as he faced harsh persecutions and experienced great sorrow. The reason we are here today to pay our respects and remember him is not simply because he was a man who was able to emerge from indescribable difficulties and challenges like a phoenix. Just as the sun keeps shining even though a rainstorm covers it, Reverend Moon lived his entire life walking the heavenly course of true love. He gave, kept giving, and continued to give while not even remembering that he had ever given. That was his philosophy on living for the sake of others.
제사를 발표했었기 때문입니다.
Reverend Moon showed us through his life that there is always hope. Just as the sun will always be there, even though there may be black clouds of rain covering it. Distinguished guests who love peace, I want to extend my heart of sincere gratitude to the host who made this event possible and for this honor of being able to give a commemorative speech. I pray that peace be upon you all. I would like to conclude my speech by reciting a poem written by Manhe Han Yong-un, a great Buddhist monk who was a great poet and a pillar of Buddhism in Korea. I carried the unfathomable power of sadness and poured it inside the new cup of hope. We meet and we worry that we will say goodbye, but we say goodbye believing one day we will meet again. Oh, you have gone, but I have not let you go. The song of love that surrenders to my voice embraces your silence. The head monk of Bulguksa. Thank you very much, everyone. Thank you very much, Mr. Songta. It was truly a beautiful poem, the remark. Now, I'd like to welcome a former Philippine speaker, Jose de Venecia, founding chairman of International Conference of Asian Political Parties, who has come from afar to cherish memories of Reverend Sun Myung-moon. He was elected as the parliament member for 5 times, and he was also a presidential candidate. And he's a very great leader in Philippines, and he always respected True Father from the deepest part of his heart. And he is our peace ambassador.
Excellencies, ambassadors for peace from all over the world, ladies and gentlemen of Korea, it is my great honor and privilege to have the opportunity to share with you a few words this morning in honor of the life, the teachings, and the work and legacy of our Father Moon. Dr. Sun Myung-moon has passed away to the spiritual world 1 year ago today. I am always moved and uplifted when I come to Chungpyo. My wife, Gina de Venecia, and I have had the very good fortune to have visited Father Moon and Mother Moon on many occasions in this holy place, in this holy land.
Gina는 이 청평이 아주 거룩한 성소요. 아주 청평이 올 때마다 강렬한
compassion shown to us by Father and Mother Moon following the tragic accident that led to the untimely passing of our beloved daughter when our house burned down.
특별히 저와 제 아내는 이곳에 올 때마다 저희가 국회의원의 의장일 때 그 의장 공간이 불이 나서 무리하게 참 16세 딸이 성화를 하게 되는데 그 큰 충격에 휩싸였을 때 청평에 왔을 때 우리 내외를 우리 참모님 양이분께서 아주 뜨겁게 배려해 주시고 격려해 주시고 그 의미를 가르쳐 주신 것에 대해서 결코 잊을 수가 없습니다.
Both of us were deeply moved by the love and the care which both Father and Mother Moon provided at that difficult time. Indeed, it was one of the most difficult times in our life, and we will never forget their generosity and loving kindness.
저희 부부는 저희들이 정말로 어렵고 힘들었을 때 저희 인생에서 참 아버님과 참 어머님의 그 따뜻한 위로와 사랑을 잊을 수가 없습니다. 저희들을 언제나 친절과 사랑으로 이끌어 주시고 격려해 주셨던 그 귀한 뜨거운 은혜를 영원히 잊을 수가 없습니다.
When I learned of Father Moon's passing 1 year ago, I was dumbfounded and I immediately came to Korea. I had seen him on so many occasions, standing before great multitudes, such as what we have today, and speaking for hours, full of dynamic passion, vitality, and almost superhuman energy. I could never imagine him getting ill, let alone dying and passing away.
1년 전에 참 아버님의 성화 소식을 들었을 때 그 충격을 감출 수가 없었습니다. 저는 그 소식을 듣는 즉시 한국에 왔습니다. 오늘 이와 같이 큰 대중집회에서 참 아버님께서 열정에 가득 차셔서 거의 초인적인 그런 에너지로 장시간을 말씀해 주시는 것을 여러 차례 목격을 할 수 있었습니다. 그래서 참 몸이 불편하셔서 성화하셨다는 것을 결코 상상조차 할 수가 없었습니다.
But of course, each of us resides on this planet Earth on borrowed time for a temporary period. Each of us is destined for a higher place with God in this spiritual world. I know that Father Moon is alive and well in this spiritual world. And you can be absolutely sure that wherever he is in that eternal world, Father Moon continues to teach and to speak with an unbounded energy that exceeds all the dynamism he once demonstrated here on this earthly plane.
물론 우리의 지상생활은 우리의 지상생활은 임시적이요 한시적인 삶인 것은 사실입니다. 우리들의 운명은 영계 즉 저 높은 곳에 가도록 운명 지어져 있습니다. 저는 확신합니다. 참 아버님은 영계에서 살아계시고 영계의 복귀를 위해 수고하고 계시다는 것을 알고 있습니다. 또는 저는 절대적으로 확신하는 것은 참 아버님께서 영계 어디에 계시든지 간에 지상생활에서 보여주셨듯이 초인간적인 초능력을 가지고 전 영계를 대상으로 말씀하시고 가르침을 주시고 계시다는 것을 믿어 의심치 않습니다.
Excellencies, people of Korea, can you imagine what I am saying is true? Is Father Moon not here today in our midst?
여러분, 기빈 여러분, 그리고 한국의 여러 지도자 여러분, 지금 제가 파더 문이 우리와 함께 하고 계시다는 것을 말씀하는 것을 믿을 수 있겠습니까?
Yes, I can see and hear that you totally agree.
나와 공감을 해 주시니 정말로 감사합니다.
In fact, I feel his presence in the mountains right here in our midst. As strong as ever, as when he walked this earth. Can't you feel his presence right here in this very Coliseum?
정말로 저는 지금 참 아버님 파드 문이 바로 지금 이 자리 이 체육관 안에 여러분과 나 사이에 계신 것을 느낍니다. 지금 여기 앉아서 우리와 함께 이 자리에 계시는 것을 느낍니다. 여러분은 느끼지 않습니까? 지금까지 바드문 마드문을 참모님 양이분을 많이 만났지만 두 분이 한 번도 서로 떨어져 계시는 것을 보지는 못했습니다. 두 양이분은 분리될 수 없는 분입니다. 지금도 영계와 육계가 하나가 되어서 참 아버님과 참 어머님 두 분은 한 분으로 계신 것을 저는 믿습니다. 여러분도 믿으십니까?
visionary and prophetic. He voiced an idea whose time has now come.
2008년 8월 참 아버님께서는 UN에서 글로벌 화해 조정기구로 초종교 의회를 UN의 상원 기능으로 제창하셨습니다. 종남간의 영적 지도자들 간의 상호 협력이 없이는 UN의 본질적인 사명은 결코 성공할 수 없다는 것을 가르쳐 주신 것입니다. 참 아버님은 참으로 위대한 비전을 가진 지도자요, 비전하리요, 예언자이십니다. 민주주의나 정부로 만들 수가 없는 것입니다. 이제 UN의 상원을 만들어서 종교 지도자 평화 운동에 앞장서야 할 그 때가 바로 지금 다시 찾아온 것입니다.
beloved people of Korea, as we go forward from this day, let us keep the vision, the memory, the word, and the heart of Father Moon close to our own hearts.
전 세계에서 오신 존경하는 지도자 여러분, 그리고 한국의 평화대사 여러분, 위에서 열거한 우리 Father Moon의 위대한 그 사명을 위해 우리가 전진합시다. 우리의 가슴 속에 Father Moon의 심정과 비전을 간직하고 그분의 대신자가 되어서 전진해 나아갑시다. 귀빈 여러분, 오늘 우리가 이 자리에 모인 것은 단순히 가신 어른을 추모하거나 슬퍼하기 위해서 모인 것은 아닙니다. 그 어른이 가시다가 우리에게 넘겨주고 하신 그 거룩한 미션을 우리가 계속해야 될 것입니다. 그 위대한 성업은 선한 싸움이 승리할 때까지 계속되어져야 할 것입니다. 예, 그렇습니다. 평화는 성취하기 어려운 것뿐이 아니라 뿐이 아닙니다. 그러나 성취 가능하다는 것입니다. 우리가 마다 뭔가 하나가 되어서 전진하게 될 때 우리는 반드시 파더문 우리에게 남기신 그 위대한 평화의 성업을 이루어 나갈 것입니다. 우리 합심하여 그것을 이루어 냅시다. 당신을 사랑합니다. 아버님, 어머님을 진심으로 사랑합니다. We love you. Thank you. 감사합니다. 우리 귀한 추모사를 해주신
Please give another big round of applause to a former parliament member Jose de Venecia for his moral address. Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you.
참으로 세 분의
The precious, significant memorial remarks that were given by the three leaders was really heart-moving. And next, we'll have a time to read the memorial poems. So first we'll read the poem that was written by Father at the age of 16, called The Crown of Glory. So please... And after the crown of glory, we'll have, representing all blessed families, we'll have a poem titled A Letter to Father, which was selected among the different poems that were written by different members around the world. And so, a very famous actress in Korea called Jung Hye-sun, a peace ambassador, would come forward and also recite this poem.
영광의 멸류관
the crown of glory. When I doubt people, I feel pain. When I judge people, it is unbearable.
When I doubt people,
when I hate people, there is no value to my existence.
It is unbearable.
Yet, if I believe, I am deceived. If I love, I am betrayed, suffering and grieving tonight, my head in my hands. Am I wrong? Yes, I am wrong.
Suffering and grieving tonight.
Even though we're deceived, still believe.
Am I wrong?
Though we're betrayed, still forgive. Love completely, even those who hate you. Wipe the tears away and welcome with a smile. Those who know nothing but deceit, and those who betray without regret. Master, the pain of loving. Look at my hands. Place your hand on my burning chest. My heart is bursting, such agony.
Place your hand on my chest.
But when I love those who acted against me, I brought victory. If you have done the same thing, I will give you the crown of glory.
If you have done the same thing.
A letter to Father. Beloved true Father, 1 year has passed since your ascension. Last summer was an extremely harsh season. The intensity of your life began even before your birth. The cries for Korea's independence on the first day of the third month in 1919 marked the conception of your life, heralding a thorny path that would be filled with tribulations, adversity, and hardship. True Father's life and youthful days were filled with extreme hardships, knowing that the Heavenly Parent was compelled to guide you on that path. We're blinded by the tears that well up from our heart. On the day you were released from Hungnam Prison, you could have chosen to visit Chungmo-nim, who was nearby. Yet, because of true love, you departed North Korea, carrying your disciple on your back who had broken his leg. On this lonely path, you follow the will of God's providence. Whenever you went beyond the pass of the path of Golgotha, you beat down and pushed back your tears. We cannot fathom the blood and tears that you shed in your heart. At the rally to save the nation held at Yeouido, your determined roar towards millions gathered there was strong. and silently you wept after reading letters from missionaries who were in prisons in communist nations. Father, may your precious body be preserved. I will see you again in the outer world. America must awake, so you cried in the land of freedom. At the Kremlin, you prayed for the end of communism. And while even embracing Kim Il-sung, Father, you wielded an iron rod towards the nations, yet to us you were always a passionate and affectionate Father. Last year, as autumn was falling upon us, the sad news that you had ascended left all of us dumbfounded. Before ascending to the heavenly nation, you gazed at True Mother's face as if to engrave her image in your heart. And you sat across True Mother at a table for two. Your last outing was your visit to Osan School, a mirror of your hometown. You went around Cheonjong-gung, sustained by an oxygen tank, saying your last farewell. When I think about your prayer, when you proclaim, it is all accomplished. Tears welled up in my eyes, and my heart aches thinking about it. Father, no matter how many times I call you, I still want to call you again. Father, I miss you dearly. You are the light of my life. You are like an ever expanding ocean to me. Father, when you suddenly ascended to the heavenly nation, we assumed that True Mother would be the most grieved. Yet, she was the first to raise the torch of true love. With Foundation Day approaching, she raised her voice and commanded, "There is no stopping. We shall advance. Invest yourself completely with a life or death resolution. You must do your best with all your heart." She raised high the torch of love. You spent each day like 1,000 years as you waited for Foundation Day. Yet one day, you let go of our hands and ascended to the heavenly nation and opened the gates to the kingdom of heaven. True Mother is now taking the lead and guiding us on the path to heaven which you had shown to us. We too shall follow true parents in this way. We shall live a life so that when we conclude our life on earth and rise to heaven, we too can proudly say we have accomplished everything.
Salaam.
nation. And we shall attend True Mother on earth and do our best to fulfill Vision 2020. We'll do our best to fulfill Vision 2020. This is our pledge. The 17th day of the 7th month by the heavenly calendar, in I recite his name in this poem in my name. Thank you. Thank you for reading this beautiful poem. And let's give another big round of applause to Peace Ambassador Jong Hye-sung for reading this poem with all her heart. Next, True Mother will come on stage for the next order. Please welcome her again with another big round of applause, everyone. Next, the Chonhyeolguk Constitution and the Public Assets White Book would be dedicated to the true parents. As you well know, True Father already spoke about the Constitution 20 years ago and emphasized enacting one whenever he had the opportunity. And now that we have ushered in the first year of Chonhyeolguk, we're accelerating our efforts in creating the environment while attending True Parents and building the foundation of Chonhyeolguk. From this providential view, 16 scholars around the world were rallied under the blessing of True Parents, and after deep research for 6 months, the Chonhyeolguk Constitution came to be formed, and different suggestions were collected through 8 public hearings from leaders in 20 or so countries, and the Constitution amended in accordance. In the future, subordinate laws, including laws related to life, will be prepared based on this constitution and will be proclaimed in front of heaven and earth on the first anniversary of Foundation Day. And now, representing all blessed families around the world, I would like to welcome Reverend Kim Young-hee, Reverend Lee Jae-suk, Reverend Hwang Song-jo, and Reverend Seok Jun-ho, our 4 former national leaders of Korea on stage to dedicate this Chonhyeolguk Constitution to heavenly parents and true parents. Please give them a big round of applause, everyone. That will become the eternal frame of Chonhyeolguk. This was Father's long hope. Next, we will dedicate the World Public Assets White Book to True Parents. Following the dedication of the Chonhyeolguk Constitution, another Chonhyeolguk pillar has been set up, and in accordance with the directions of True Parents, the Mission Foundation analyzed and organized all public assets of the education community worldwide and have compiled the White Book on Public Assets in the World. 9,959 assets scattered in 81 countries has been compiled within the 23 volumes of the extensive World Public Asset White Book. This White Book will be dedicated by Peter Kim and Dr. Park Noe. Please welcome them with a big round of applause as they come in. This is an extensive compilation of 20 made consisting of 23 volumes, and these are public assets that will be used to realize God's will for eternity on earth. Please again give a big round of applause again to the true parents who have accepted the 23 volumes. Thank you again. Next, we will listen to True Mother's message. But first, we will watch a video of True Mother who stood up strong after Father Songhwa for and standing at the front line of the Providence, guiding us and directing us. And so we have taken the essential excerpts from her messages and compiled it on a video. So please let us all watch this video together. Thank you. I proclaim a new start as the entire global unification community makes the determination to become one with True Parents' will and fulfill the tribal Messiah mission at all costs. I declare to our Heavenly Parent that Chunilguk has been set as the name of the country, roses and lilies as the national flowers, and the crane as the national bird. I dedicate the national anthem and flag in front of heaven. Today is indeed a day of gratitude and joy. True Father's accomplishments are gem-like true words of truth to fallen humanity. I am immensely happy and grateful to see True Father's teachings become beautiful, precious stones that have not been dispersed, but threaded onto one line. And now that we stand in a position where we must accelerate the Chunilguk era, these teachings will become the substantial center of Chunilguk. It will become its fruit and pillars. How happy would heaven be if you could become one with these teachings and fulfill all of your given responsibilities and missions in your respective positions. As people in the year 2020, I said that we must make Korea God's homeland at all costs. This cannot be realized just by saying so. We need to practice in order to make it come true. You must move. And you must be reborn through the truth. And you must become the torches of light to the people out there. So, your efforts will become like the fertilizers of Chunilguk. You will become the pillars in establishing Chunilguk. I will give greater support to those people who contribute to peace in all walks of life and to talented people so that they may play greater roles in the future. So the future will be bright if we put more effort, move more, share more, and practice true love. If we do so, our future will definitely be brighter. A happier world will dawn. Your lives today
영양소가 되고
will become the nutrients of the future and will
땅 앞에 특별히 여러분들이 같은 시대에
as people who live in the same age as true mother
삶을 살았던 사람으로서의 특별한 자격
This gives you special qualifications and special authority. This is where you stand. So all of you, every single one of you, have the potential to become beautiful gems. So what I hope for my descendants and our children is our filial children and patriots. And based on the second generation and third generation members, it is my hope to expand this realm. And so, as time passes by, we only have hope. Blessed. Beloved, blessed families and members from around the world, I am truly proud of you. You must be able to repay heaven at all costs. You must succeed at all costs. You must show to our heavenly parent and the true parents of heaven, earth, and humankind that the kingdom of God on earth and in heaven has begun. Do you understand? So please bear in mind that it is our responsibility and mission as people living in this age to follow this path with a life or death resolve, investing in it with all our might and advancing without rest. Please bear this in mind. Heavenly Parent, only after 6,000 years, through the returning Lord, did God's lonely, sad 6,000 years resentment was resolved. Heavenly parents waited for this one day with a concerned heart that maybe the central figures might give up in the middle. He went through indescribable pain and time. And
while,
as blessed families, with the love we received from God and true parents, we were actually very small in comparison. We're very inadequate, but enable our dreams to become the dream of heavenly parents and true parents. And the dream that true parents and heavenly parents wanted to achieve, may we and God achieve that one family under God centered on true love, enable us to realize that world, that country, enable us to
하늘 부모님과 인류의 소망인 하나님의 조국으로 설 수 있게끔
enable us to really stand on your homeland and please become people who can do everything for that.
나는 이 순간부터 환경 창조를 시작합니다.
I will start working on the creation of the environment from this moment. True Father always said that there is no completion through ignorance. He conducted education in all aspects of different fields regardless of the status of the audience. He awakened people. That is true. This is the only path that can bring unity from the individual, family, tribe, and country to the world. For this reason, I will put my first priority on education. That That is why future leaders are being fostered, and all leaders from different walks of life must first be educated. This is the path to world peace. The world is now running centered on true parents. The heavenly fortune coming down through the true parents of heaven, earth, and humankind will be with you. So please become victors at all costs. Thank you. True mother emphasized and advanced without rest. So please give again another big round of applause to true mother and stand for your position, please. And welcome true mother for a big round of applause. Thank you. Please be seated, everyone. Distinguished guests, and all the memorial remarks that moved our hearts and that brought us together, I'd like to convey my gratitude and all blessed families and members around the world. Today, we have become one. And even now, Father is looking at us with this big, beautiful smile. And as you, have you all been doing well? I feel Father would be doing this right now. Peace ambassadors, members, we, from now on, at this very time, with one, we have become one in heart and in mind. True Father, who gave us this great teachings, and as we commemorate his accomplishments, we made the determination that we'll realize true parents' will at all costs. On this Songhua, centered on this Songhua event memorial, Korea and Japan have become one. And so from now on, from August 3rd, they set off. There was a peace march that started off in Japan, and via Busan, and they would march all the way to Imjingang. And so they had this bicycle march for peace, with the hope to realize unification of North and South Korea. So our conditions and dedication should not end at Im Jin Gang. It should pass the Two Mountain, pass Asia, and move on to the whole world. And in realizing the free and peaceful world, the kingdom of heaven on earth, let us advance till we achieve this kingdom of heaven on earth. On this very good day, with all the distinguished guests and all the beloved members and blessed families, True Father, is living in our hearts. Let us all become one with Him. And realize Heavenly Parents and True Parents' will on earth while we're still alive. We will become these filial children who do so. We'll become loyal subjects who do so. At this, it is my hope that this time become a time for you to make this determination, everyone. Thank you. Please give again another big round of applause again to True Mother for her words of encouragement to all of us. True Mother, thank you. Thank you again. Thank you.
And we hereby conclude the first part of our event, and soon after we will begin our second part of the event. So please be seated and let us participate in the second part of this event.
Through
the first part, we have listened to the mother's speech as the conclusion. And now, towards the Vision 2020, we will shout out. And soon we will begin the second part of this event. Please be seated. Today, this beautiful screen that you are watching at this moment. So the beautiful screen you are watching now is 24 meters in width and 9 meters in height. It is the latest mega LED screen. Here, 576 boxes that are 50 centimeters wide and high have been put together. This LED is also 3 times brighter than the existing ones, and its pixel size is 3 millimeters, which is smaller than the existing 9 millimeters, making the screen more vivid. Please give an... So this is it is very crystal clear, and please give another big round of applause to all the staffs who have prepared this beautiful stage. And now, we'll begin our commemorative performances, and first, the grandchildren of Reverend Sun Myung-moon and Dr. Hak Ja-han Moon will sing songs that True Father liked. The future leaders, our second generation and third generation children, they will sing three songs. And as they show us the performance, please welcome them with a round of warm applause.
감사합니다.
감사합니다.
선야님들과 인생 3세로 구성된 아름다운 추억의 노래 불러주셨습니다. 다시 한번 뜨거운 감사의 박수로
축하합니다. Other second generation and third generation member children have given us a wonderful performance. Let us thank them with a warm round of applause. Again, let us thank them with a round of warm applause. And now, from far away from South America, a world-level singer, her name is Gloria. She came. She has come here today in order to pay her respect to True Father. And she has an experience of singing in many different places. And she participated in our events many times and sang for True Parents. Let us welcome her with a warm round of applause.
thank you. That was indeed a heart-moving song. Please give her again another big round of applause, everyone. Next, it's time for a chorus, and the chorus consists of 93 students from Japan, and it's called the Japanese Sonha Chorus. They won a gold prize at a chorus contest, and the title of their songs is Feel Piety, and one of father's favorite songs called Furusato Shiawase. And Feel Piety, the song Feel Piety was prepared as we approached father's memorial, and it was a song that father really loved, and it'll be sung in the medley style. Please welcome them again with another big round of applause as they come on stage.
Thank you.
was indeed heart-moving songs. This is a chorus made of 93 Japanese students called the Sonhak Chorus. They had to learn Korean to learn to sing these songs. Please give them again another big round of applause again to our Sonhak Chorus. As you well know, Furusato means a hometown and Shiawase means happiness. These two songs were father's favorite songs. Now is the time to have our highlight, the highlight of this memorial performances. And so we'll have now a gala show musical commemorating father's life on March 22nd right here in Chongshim World Center as to commemorate the opening of the Chongshim World Peace Center, a musical titled The Crown of Glory, which basically highlighted father's life in 30 minutes. This musical was planned and produced by the Chongshim Peace World Center and is titled The Crown of Glory. Please give them another big round of applause, everyone.
Thank you. Thank you. God, you have made me stand alone. I am a wife of a man. I am the wife of a man, and I am the mother of 14 children. How could I not feel pain and suffering in front of this course of great indemnity? I have sent many of my children before me. Promise that I have made to you. and I will endure everything. And I will endure, and I will endure everything with solid heart. Sacrifices and sufferings. It seemed as if the suffering and persecution against true father and true mother would never end. This persecution is the last attack of Satan. I am not afraid. I have endured many persecutions. This is all the predestined providence for father. And I will defeat it, and I will overcome it. The revelation that you have bestowed us upon us, this mind and this body belong to you.
Peak of darkness.
this, even though there was countless persecutions and sufferings, true parents of heaven, earth, and humankind put more efforts into bringing salvation to humanity. And they achieved things that was only that were only in dreams. What are you so happy about? Look, heavenly parents are smiling like this. Heavenly parent, you're happy, right? I see your smiles. Many people, through the messages of True Father, they have received the salvation and the eternal life. And we too. Oh God, who have sent us, oh heavenly parents, who have sent us the true parents of heaven and humankind for our salvation. Thank you very much. And true parents of heaven, earth, and humankind who have taught us the real meaning of true love. We love you truly. My beloved children and family members, through the efforts in your works, we have finally welcomed this age of Chanyeol. Without your efforts and without your, all your sufferings and pain, we would not have been able to welcome this glorious day. You've worked so hard. We laughed and we cried together for the past 60 years. And all these days, I remember every one of them. And all these course of providence that I have spent with you, that they are engraved in each of my bones. Because I was with you, I was so happy. But my body is in charge of room. My spirit dwells in the hearts of every one of you. And I will always grieve together with you. Now is the age of Chunhyuk. This earth, true mother, will lead you with her warm hands. And in the spirit world, I will protect you. And I will become your light. And I will shed light on the path that you walk. Let us unite. Let us bring the world of true love. And let us fulfill, let us complete, and let us perfect the ideal of creation. I truly implore you not to forget your mission and my burning heart will always flow. So please use my love as the power that drives you. I love you. Love you. I love you. My wife, my true mother, who have been with me for more than 50 years, how do I thank you enough? My husband, my true father, I love you so much. You have accomplished so much that cannot be described by words. You've achieved something great that can only be done by true parents. Now people are marching forward to Vision 2020 with their hearts united. So please, for all the members who are in the spirit world, for all the members who are here today, please help us from the spirit world. And I ask you. And I already know your wish and your hope. And from the spirit world, I will use all my hearts and devotions to support you, to help you. And thank you for protecting my will. I love you, my wife. Oh, you who have been always stood beside me. You are the one that I cannot do without. You are my true partner whom God gave me. And you do not need to speak a word. Your unfathomable love, you are a partner that I received from God. This path of true love that God allowed us to walk. No persecution will stop us. No hardship will stop us. There are still many things that we have to do. And I do not know how much more hardship I will have to put you through. since we were wedded in a holy marriage when I was 17 years old. I have considered everything that I have received from you, all the time that I spent with you, as the blessing that I received from God. Please be with me forever. True parents, for the past 50 years, I am truly grateful for all the works that you have done. However, still, there are so many people out there who are waiting for you to reach to them. So go. Go to the people who wait for true love. I will always be with you. Father, watch over us. We will not stop. We will march forward without stopping. Thank you, true parents. This glorious miracle Ladies and gentlemen, it was truly a moving performance. Thank all the performers for that heart-moving show.
Our heart of marching forward for the Vision 2020.
애창곡 조국 창가와 그리고
엄마야. They will sing us the songs that your parents loved.
우리 마지막 그랜드 휘날레를 위해서 이 자리에 참석하신 모든 내외 귀인 여러분, 우리 저우 모두 자리에 일어서셔서 함께 희망찬 향해
let us sing together to show to true parents our heart of gratitude and our heart of yearning to march forward for Vision 2020.
천상의 참 아버님과 참 어머님께 뜨거운 마음을 모아 오늘 마지막 순서로 일본 송영 전 총회장께서 나오셔서 억만세 삼창을 선창해 주겠습니다. 우리 모두의 열망을 담아서 우리 함성으로
Let us all shout three cheers of Okmanse with all our hearts and a big voice to our heavenly parents Okmanse. To our victorious true parents of heaven, earth, and humankind, Okmanse. And to the establishment of Chonugok. So as we conclude this, let us all offer gratitude to your parents before we conclude the whole event. Everyone, please get ready.
경배.
Down.
바로.
Thank you.
여러분 전진 참모님께 감사의 마음을
give
담아
a big round of applause again to our true parents.
참모님 감사합니다.
Everybody, let's all say thank you to true parents.
참모님,
thank
감사합니다.
You, true parents. Thank you, true parents.
참모님 사랑합니다.
True parents, we love you.
대단히 감사합니다.
Thank you very much. And with this, we'll end
천주성화 1주년 추모식의
the first anniversary of the universal Songhwa of Sun Myung-moon, the true parents of heaven, earth, and humankind.
예, 감사합니다.
Thank you,
사랑하는 여러분,
loving brothers and sisters.
잠시만 앉으시겠습니다.
Would like to ask all members to please be seated for a short time because we have a lot of traffic outside and the launch will commence soon in Cheonjong-gung and so those who are scheduled to participate in the launch please follow the directions of the ushers who will guide you to your buses and so for the other members I would like again to ask you to please wait a little bit until the rest of speeding in the launch and leave and the station now is open to all members who want to take photos to commemorate or remember this significant day.